Welcome to Warthunder Ground Forces in Realistic Battle. Today we'll have a closer look at a downtier match in the Tiger 2P on a pretty difficult map in my opinion. But first let's have a look at my BPM. The initial spawn costs of my Tiger 2P tell me that the BR is 6.7 and with my 6.3 lineup it's kind of a downtier match. So I have a good gun and some armor I can use in this match. Therefore, I choose my Tiger 2P with the purpose to brawl at the capture points. In the description or in the upper right corner you'll find a link to a video where I explain what I actually mean by BPM. The map we got is Ardennes with Domination. And as I said in the intro, this map is kind of difficult in my opinion. The advantage is that everything is focused on capturing and holding B. But with all the buildings, trees and bushes around B, there will be a lot of enemy tanks trying to flank and sneak around town. But let's jump right into the battle and see how the match will evolve. On the map I can see that B is already going to be captured by the enemy team. And my teammate also highlighted an enemy on the map. As I enter the passage between the two houses, I can see a shadow of another tank, first on the wall and then before me on the ground. And there we have our first enemy tank trying to sneak around in the town. Due to the circumstance that I have one of the best tanks in this match, I will brawl at B. Therefore, I like to drive right to the center of the town, but on the right side, where I have some hull down positions and the long main road I can overlook. This is very important when you play with German tanks. Slow turret rotation speed, no early stabilizers, slow tanks but good armor and guns are all indicators for me to play German tanks with more distance instead of close combat. And the main road at the center of the town at B is perfect for this. I can shoot and back up into a safer position to reload and lure the enemy to drive into the open. You can see on the minimap that my team is doing really great. We have a proper front line and therefore I can assume that no enemy tank is trying to flank me. So I know I can push at B. But I always have to keep in mind that I would have a disadvantage in close combat situations with my German tanks, and so I use the small piles of rubble to hide my tank and overlook the main road at B. I like how that Tiger 1 is pushing, I got his back. After my team captured B, I can see on the minimap how the rest of my team is pushing further. So I have to push with them to hold up the front line, especially on this map. As we got close to A, I decide to leave the main road and spread out, because the enemy won't be just sitting around at A, but rather try to clear and capture B. So I have to open the front line and try to ensure that no enemy tank will sneak through. And just in this moment a T-34 appears. My team tries to capture A, so I push further to help them. Again, I try to hide my tank behind some solid cover, but in this situation I put myself in a dangerous position. First, I missed my shot on the M18, but I wanted to destroy him. So I turn my turret towards the capture point, knowing that the enemy is approaching from my left side and expose the side of my turret. I was really lucky that the enemy missed that shot, same as the M18 was lucky that I missed my shot. I guess the enemy saw the dust of my shot and knew I was there. But now I know that there has to be another enemy tank and I have to find him. I can detect the enemy through all the bushes by the movement of his tank and take him out. After that, we were able to capture the last point and we won the match. In the end, I destroyed 7 tanks and helped my team to win this match. I think the key for victory in this match was the proper frontline we held up the whole time. I hope I was able to give you some tips and you enjoyed this video. Like, subscribe and leave some comments if you want to. Hope to see you in-game soon.